This project is sponsored under the EGIFT scheme of the NGO One World South Asia. Before the field trial, the team tested the safety aspects of working with an envelope inflated with hydrogen. What if the hydrogen burned due to a spark? Would there be an explosion and grave danger to the team members? A capsule-shaped test balloon, previously used for an indoor airship, was used for this test. It was inflated with hydrogen and intentionally set to fire using a torch ignited with biodiesel. The balloon came down slowly, crumpled like a piece of tissue paper under an invisible bulldozer, and burnt with a colorless flame. The orange flame you see is of the plastic burning. This test gave the confidence to the trial team that it was quite safe to work with hydrogen. This is the Baba Sahib Ambedkar Technological University, Lonere, located around 150 kilometers from IIT Bombay. The university provided the team with the logistic support and accommodation. The aerostat envelope was spread on a plastic sheet to ready it for inflation with air and to test it for any air leaks. The actual process of inflation was long drawn out and tedious using an electrical blower. Finally, the air inflated envelope was secured to a customized wooden stand with three supports, and the team went to catch up on some well-deserved nutrition. Upon their arrival, they found that the envelope had fallen off the stands and had rolled off to the opposite fence thanks to the overpowering windy situation. May 25th. The team, a little bit wiser, shifted their operations indoor. Inside an auditorium provided by the university, they went ahead with testing the spherical and ellipsoidal envelopes for any air leaks. Exhausted with a night out they had had to pull off the day before, the team decided to retire. May 26th. After the incident that had happened with a bigger aerostat due to heavy winds, the team decided to take trials on a small backup spherical balloon in order to realize the concept on a smaller scale by establishing communication. Simultaneously, they also wanted to observe the severity of winds at a lower altitude. It was 5 a.m. in the morning when the team, step by step, started the integration of the balloon and all the other attachments, including the winch, the holding lines, the confluence lines, the tether, and the router box, which contained the transmitter and the antenna. All these were attached to the envelope, followed by the inflation of the balloon with hydrogen. It took a long time as expected, but finally the envelope was buoyant and ready, and so were the spirits of the team members. Some team members then proceeded to a client site located approximately 2.5 kilometers away with all the other attachments, and the communication link was tested. Mission accomplished. Communication was established with a pinging delay between 2 to 150 milliseconds and TXRX reading of minus 70 to minus 85 dBm. May 27th. Filled with increased confidence due to the success of their earlier trials, the team decided to establish communication with the bigger envelope. The team made an important observation that the atmosphere remains reasonably calm during the night. To take advantage of that, the team started preparing the bigger balloon from 11 p.m. Unfortunately, during the inflation, the available hydrogen was quite less than required. The team decided that air would be filled to get the shape of the balloon to some extent. Despite this, the team experienced tremendous lift, finding the aerostat difficult to hold. Communication payload and other things were attached. The aerostat was slowly raised to an altitude of 85 to 90 meters. Some team members went to a client site located 7.5 kilometers from where the balloon had originally been set up. The winds refused to relent, but the perseverance of the team took over. And hey presto, once again communication could be established with a pain delay between 3 to 500 and THRX reading of minus 81 to minus 92 dBm, which is good enough for voice as well as data communications. By now the winds were getting very heavy, and therefore it was time to recover and pack up the whole activity.